We have seen a lot of updates to the cars and the teams at the Spanish Grand Prix this weekend, but boy, has there been no bigger controversy than that Aston Martin car, hey? In fact, Red Bull have picked up on this themselves and directly accused Aston Martin of copying their car and questioning whether any of their intellectual property has been stolen to make those updates. That's a pretty huge accusation to make, obviously stealing other people's property and then modifying your car with that property, pretty big deal. So what do we think's gone on here then? To take you all back to the start of the weekend, Aston Martin did show up in Spain with new side pod design and new floor design, very closely mirroring Red Bull's. Now, that's not inherently a bad thing. Obviously, they've had plenty of time to look at Red Bull's car, and Red Bull is one of the front runners, so they will be looking at that car a lot to try and learn what works on that car, what doesn't work on that car. And then, yeah, copying is the sincerest form of flattery. If your car's not doing well, perhaps you should copy one that is doing well, right? It makes logical sense. However, Red Bull's big takeaway is that they've recently lost a number of key people, including Dan Fallows, the former head of aerodynamics, to Aston Martin. He literally started his job in April, so to be honest, I don't think he's going to have made much of a difference to this Aston Martin car so far. But Red Bull are putting two and two together. They're saying, hey, we lost a lot of people to Aston Martin. Hey, Aston Martin car suddenly looks a lot like ours. So they're kind of worried that some of those people may have taken some property that they perhaps shouldn't have done. Of course, Aston Martin do deny this. I don't think they would ever admit to it, right? They do deny it, and they say they have provided the FIA with legitimate paperwork, resources. The technical team at the FIA is involved in looking at how Aston Martin came up with these upgrades, and the FIA themselves have said they are legit, that this was a original piece of work, no IP was infringed upon. So that should be it. Dead, right? The FIA's ruled on it, we're all good. However, we're starting to see those cracks now. Nobody really trusts the FIA after last year, and Red Bull have issued a statement after the FIA's response saying that they noted the FIA statement with interest, and should any transfer of IP have taken place, that would clearly breach the regulations. So they clearly think this isn't over. They're going to keep pursuing it. And boy, we could be in for a long one on this. And what probably doesn't help Aston Martin's case is that they have form in doing this previously. If you remember back to 2020 when they were racing as Racing Point, they were accused and found guilty of illegally copying parts of the Mercedes car. For that, they were docked 15 points and fined €400,000 for breaking those rules. So now, a lot of people are thinking, hey, they did it once, have they done it again? And I think that's going to be a big kind of talking point for Red Bull when it comes to this accusation as well. We're definitely not going to get this resolved over the course of Spanish Grand Prix, but it is something that's interesting to see it rumble on for a little bit, I think. And it'll also be interesting to see where Aston Martin end up now that they've got these Red Bull-esque side pods on, right? But what do you guys think? Do you think Aston Martin could have done this? Do you think they could have copied? Let me know in the comments or over on social media at Race Report Pod. I will be doing a race review on the Sunday night for the race itself, so feel free to follow or subscribe or tune in on Sunday night for that.